Savage with your news briefing. The definition of who is considered a close contact is changing from midnight after a snap meeting between state leaders. Scott Morrison confirming only those who live with someone who has the virus or has spent more than 4 hours with a positive case will be forced to isolate. The Prime Minister says the plan to live with the virus has not changed.
We've agreed a very practical way forward to dealing with the realities of Omicron. It also recognises, as always, that all states and territories have largely different situations on the ground.
The isolation period is also changing down to 10 days for those with COVID and 7 days for vaccinated close contacts. More than 21,000 COVID cases have been confirmed across Australia today, along with our youngest casualty. South Australian authorities confirming a COVID positive child under the age of 2 has passed away, although the official cause of death is still under investigation. In New South Wales, more than 12,000 people have tested positive, more than 5,000 in Victoria, more than 2,000 in Queensland. In the nation's capital, protesters have set fire to the front doors of Old Parliament House in Canberra. Former Deputy Prime Minister Michael McCormack says it's a disgrace and an outrageous attack on Australia's democracy. Police are looking into how the blaze started. And overseas in New York, Ghislaine Maxwell has been found guilty of 5 out of 6 charges of recruiting teenage girls to be sexually abused by Jeffrey Epstein. She could face decades in prison.
Selling the family home. Melbourne and John, I put you first.
Another blow for England ahead of the fourth Ashes test. Head coach Chris Silverwood has been forced into isolation after the touring party recorded its 7th COVID case. He'll have to isolate for 10 days with his family in Melbourne, while another round of PCR tests are undertaken later today. And in tennis, we're no closer to knowing if Novak Djokovic will compete in the Australian Open. The world number one has pulled out of this weekend's ATP Cup in Sydney, adding to the speculation he won't grace the court at Melbourne Park.
Clear skies for the Limestone Coast, dropping to 13 degrees overnight. Tomorrow, mostly sunny, a top of 37 degrees, cooling off a bit on Saturday, a top of 31. And the Listener app is the new home of your local news. Join now to listen live or on demand.